Today, we're talking about Google Docs, not to be confused with Google Drive. They are not the same thing. And don't worry, I'll talk a little bit more about that later. So now that I've cleared that up, or maybe created some more confusion, on with the show. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custode and welcome back to my YouTube channel where I share tech tips, app reviews, and so much Google content, it should be illegal. So today I'm gonna cover how Google Docs is different from Google Drive, and then I'm gonna share the best Google Docs features for 2022. We have a lot to cover, so you ready? Then let's go. So first things first, Google Drive and Google Docs often get confused. And as I said so eloquently at the top, they are not the same thing. So I want you to think of Google Drive as your storage unit. And your storage unit contains all kinds of different files. Here's what I mean. So these files can be sheets, slides, forms, photos, and more. And you can organize all of these files how you see fit within Google Drive. So Google Docs are one of these file types that are created, stored, and shared within Google Drive. So a Google Doc is basically Google's answer to Microsoft Word. Though, as you'll see, it's a lot more than that. Are you following now? Okay, good. So now that you understand the difference between Google Drive and Google Docs, let's jump right into some of the best Google Docs features. And we're gonna start with the all new Pageless view. So Pageless format lets you remove the boundaries of a page. So here's a document of mine that's not Pageless. And here's what it looks like in Pageless view. All you have to do is head to File, then Page Setup, then select Pageless and tap on OK. With Pageless enabled, there are no page breaks and images adjust to your screen size. Wide tables are viewable by scrolling left and right. Now, when you do this, it could look different than what you're seeing on my screen, and that's because changing to Pageless is document specific, meaning everyone who interacts with your document will see the Pageless view, but changing the setting for one document isn't going to impact the other documents you own. So I changed this doc to Pageless, but if I toggle over to another doc of mine, you can see I have not changed that specific doc to Pageless, so it's the original Pages view. But that's not all you can do with Pageless view. You can actually select a custom text width too. So from a Pageless doc, if you head to View, then select Text Width, you can select a width of narrow, medium, or wide. Now this particular text setting will apply to all Pageless docs that you view, but it won't affect what others see. So you're just changing the text width on your end. It's also important to know that some features like columns, page numbers, headers and footers, and so on are not available on Pageless view. So if you need those, you're gonna have to switch back to the original Pages view. Now, before we move on to more 2022 specific Google Docs features, I wanna take a minute to give a special mention to three features that aren't actually new to 2022, but they're little known features that could change the way you use Google Docs. And I wanna start with the text substitution feature. This is something that's gonna allow you to automatically replace your text in Google Docs. So all you have to do is head on up to the menu bar and click on Tools, then choose Preferences. From this pop-up window, click on Substitutions. In this pop-up, you should have a whole whack of substitutions already populated for you. But to add your own custom ones, just type them in at the top. So let's say you want a short form for the phrase YouTube video. In the replace field, let's type in YTV, and then in the width field, let's type in YouTube video. And then just hit on OK. Now, every time you type YTV, boom, it automatically changes to YouTube video for you. And you can do this trick for any short form or phrase that you want. And by the way, any new substitutions you create will always be added to the bottom of this list for you if you ever want to turn them off or change them. And always make sure that the automatic substitutions option is toggled on. All right, now let's learn another great Google Doc feature. Did you know that you can automatically change capitalization quickly in your doc? Well, you can, and this is going to save you so much time. So let's say you use Google Docs to take notes during a meeting and you don't have time to capitalize things properly. Rather than go back and capitalize each individual letter one at a time, you can do this much quicker. Select the text you want to capitalize, and then head on up to Format and hover over the text option, then hover over the capitalization option. Here, you can select the desired type of caps that you want, so lowercase, uppercase, or title case. The capitalization will change automatically for you. Easy as that. Okay, up next is the ability to make a copy of your Google Docs directly. So instead of sharing your precious Google Doc that you don't trust another soul with, or making copy upon copy on your own end, you can actually share your doc directly and force the user that's opening it to make a copy on their end. Here's how it works. So of course, you could take a bunch of extra clicks and head to File, and then select make copy in order to make a copy. But then from there, you'd have to share the copy out and you'd have like a bunch of copies stored on your drive. And it really becomes this whole thing. So instead of you making your own copies, you can easily set it so someone else has to make a copy in order to access your doc. So first things first, this is important. You want to make sure that in your share settings that they are set to anyone with a link or public in order for this URL trick to work. Then let's head on up to our URL and see here at the end where it says edit, we're simply going to replace the word edit with the word copy. I swear to you, it is that simple. Now you can just copy and paste this URL wherever you need to, whether it's to share it with a colleague, add to your website, pop it into an email, whatever it is, you can just share this link. So now, when a user clicks on this new link, they're going to be prompted to make a copy of the file. Once they do this, a copy will be made and added to their Google Drive. How neat is that? By the way, I realize this is just a Google Docs video, but this same URL trick works with Sheets and Slides too. Okay, so now let's move on to some more Google Doc features for 2022. And this next feature is made possible by Google's Smart Canvas. Google introduced Smart Canvas in 2021 at their Google I/O event, and it's really a bunch of new features that make docs even more interactive and collaborative and smart. Now, many of these Smart Canvas features announced are purely for Google Workspace users, and that's a paid service, but there are a couple great freebies available to those of us who don't have Workspace. So one of the cool Smart Canvas features that's available to free users is Google's Smart Chips. Think of this as tagging to the next level. With Smart Chips, you can not only tag people using the at symbol followed by a name, but you can use the at symbol to get information on files, dates, and events as well. So as you can see, you just need to type at, and then a search menu is going to appear for you. To narrow this down, you can either search through the suggestions in the list or enter letters, numbers, or symbols. So for example, let's add a date. So you could just type in at today or tomorrow or yesterday or even a specific date. But see here, the date appears. So just hit on tab to select that date. Now you've created a smart chip that you can hover over to view related information. And you can simply click on the chip in order to edit it. Plus, you can head to the settings gear from here to edit the date format if you want. So again, if you want to add a smart chip for a document rather than a date, just hit your at symbol and then search for the document you want to add. And then when you find it, just hit tab to insert that smart chip. The cool thing with smart chips is that they are dynamic. So if I were to update this document we just added as a smart chip, this chip will always link to obviously the most up-to-date version of the document. Now remember, this works for people, files, lists, media, headlines, calendar events, page components, and more. Now something else to note is that say you put a link into your Google Doc, you'll automatically be prompted to hit tab if you want to add that link as a smart chip. pretty neat. Now, an honorable mention here is Google's new inclusive language feature. Now, this is like a big upgrade to their assistive writing feature. Now, there's a but, and it's a big but. This is not yet live on my free Google account. So this may just be a paid workspace feature, but it's a good one for sure. So this new inclusive language tool helps remove gendered language or ableist language automatically. So during last year's Google I/O, we were shown an example of this in action, and they actually used the term chairman, and we were given the option to use chairperson or chair instead, which is a gender neutral alternative. Now, this goes beyond that one tiny example, but here's the thing. It's still not an active feature for me in my free Google account. So if you have a paid Google Workspace account, let me know if this inclusive language feature is working for you. But if you have a free Google account, give it a try and also let me know if you have this feature or not. I don't know if it's just a glitch or not, but it would be a real shame to limit this inclusivity feature to only paid users. So I'm coming to you for help. We'll get to the bottom of this together. So those are the best Google Docs features for 2022. And now I want to hear from you. What are your favorite Google Docs features and why? Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I want to know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel and here for even more Google Drive content. Thanks so much for watching. See you next time.